check out the edge. Looks like it's holding up very well. Good tempering. Here's the damage to the barrel versus the edge. Tip. No edge rolling, no real damage. You can see the holes it's putting in there. Slight edge damage, but it held up well. Leather's still tight. Move up. Here is the Badland 2's edge after that. Here is edge damage, side by side. Sorry about the shaky camera. You can see that. Holding up there. Looks like it's holding up very well. You can check out the edge. Here you go, get close to that. Here's the edge versus the metal pole. We'll continue on, striking further. You can see it stayed straight. Leather's still tight, grip is still tight. Here is the edge damage. It did booger up the edge, but that's nothing a little grind will take care of. So it's very solid, hold up well. Proud of this design. Hello, Jason Woodard here with my final thoughts on my newest sword design. This is the Badland Katana 2. I have put it through the ringer. I have cut jugs with it, metal, wood, steel drum, and striking it against granite. Everything held up very well. It feels good in the hand. It's very solid, very strong sword. It's got a leather wrap grip. It balances just a few inches past the guard. Overall, very, very happy with this design. It held up very well. I'd like to thank Chris Palmer for his hard work for bringing this new design to life, and thank Paul Southern for our Doomsday line with Sword Buyer's Guide. This is a Sword Buyer's Guide exclusive. Pulled up very well. The most damage it took was from striking granite, of course, which it boogered up the edge just a little bit. That's nothing that grinding can't take down. Pulled up very well. If you'd like to get one of these, it also has a buffalo hide leather sheath that it fits in very well. These are all made in the USA by Chris Palmer to order. So thank you guys. The Doomsday line is doing very well. I really appreciate all the support, and new designs are coming soon. So thank you guys. I will catch you next time.